I teach early and medieval church history. Church history, you might be thinking. Why in the world would I study church history? Isn't church history just a string of dry and dreary facts that's irrelevant to my life as Christians? Well, I'd encourage you to think of church history as essentially theology taught by examples. You could think of the example of Athanasius, who stood against the world in his defense of the deity of Christ. You could think of the example of Augustine, who teaches us that we'll never be satisfied until we find our rest in the grace of the triune God. Or you'll think of the example of Bernard of Clairvaux, who reminds us that we are to love God for who He is, not simply for what He does for us. Or we can think of the example of John Wycliffe, the morning star of the Reformation, who teaches us that God's Word is for every person. Therefore, every person must have the Bible translated in his or her language. So, church history is not irrelevant. It's not dry or dreary. Church history is theology taught by example. And in this class, we'll be telling the story of church history from the days following the apostles all the way up till the dawn of the Reformation. I hope you'll join me.